Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Anita Sheelam. I am working as an assistant professor of St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, I am giving to lecture laser topic. Laser. Light acronym of laser is light amplification stimulated emission of radiation. Okay? Light amplification of stimulated
emission
by radiation. So in that light, what is light? Light is a group of photons. That is intensity. Next, amplification. Amplification goes to increase the light intensity process. Next, what is stimulated? Stimulated meaning of stimulated mean giving to some external energy in the form of photons in this lasers. Next, what is emission? The process of external energy, photons will release the some energy. Process of giving external photon, the photon will release the some energy. That is emission process. Next, what is radiation? Radiation is the process of emission and absorption. Total energy is called radiation. Before going to the topic, compare to normal light and laser light. Differ from the normal light, laser is very advantage. Next, general applications. Applications are nowadays any technology related to laser, that is medical, electrical, health and space, any technologies involved to the laser. Later classes applications will discuss. Now, matter is made up of Universe is made up of matter and energy. Matter and energy. Based on atomic structure, matter is divided three levels: solid, liquid, gases. Based on atomic structure. Atom. Atom is a group of nucleons and electrons. Combination of nucleon and electron is called as atom. Group of atoms is called molecule. Atom shape is well known are spherical shape. So atom consists of nucleon and electron. So nucleon charge is positive and electron charge is negative. Structure of atom, spherical shape. So it consists of some energy levels that called as orbitals, like K, L, M, N. From first order is L, M, N taking. Taking the one hydrogen atom. Hydrogen atom consists of 1H1. In that, one only energy state. Then energy states gives the first orbital goes to one electron. Then second, take the helium. Helium atom consists of two electrons. Second electron also goes to the first energy state, because this filling of energy electrons, one formula also given, 2n². So in that n means what is the electrons number. In that 2n means in hydrogen one only, and 2 means n means the orbital number. Orbital number is first one, 2, k means k one only. How many? 2 only. Maximum capable to fill the first orbital only 2 electrons. And second orbital, based on atomic structures, orbital will be filled. Then external energy applied to the supplied to the atomic structure, this energy levels goes to the excited state. Means jump to the one state, to lower level state, to higher level state. In excited state, there is no longer time in excited state. It will transition from the excited to the downward state. Then some release, that time release some energy, that is called emission of energy or emission of radiation. Emission, the form of energy. This process is called as radiation. Consider the one solid material supply the external energy. That solid material consists of atoms. Atoms absorbed by the external energy, it will move or it will transit to the ground state, atoms to excited state. Same process, there is no long time in excited state, excited atoms will move to downwards transition, then emit the some energy. Energy. This process of absorption and emission is called as emission and absorption. Is called as radiation. Okay. Next. In that, radiation is 3 types. Radiation is 3 types. Taking the same process, one orbital, external energy, it moves to the, means transition from ground state to excited state. 3 process, that is 3 types of radiation. One is spontaneous stimulated absorption. Second is spontaneous emission. Emission of radiation. Third one is stimulated emission of radiation. Photon. Atom, this photon absorbed by the ground state to excited state. In second case, this is absorption only. The external energy absorbed by the atom, that state is known as stimulated absorption. Stimulated absorption. Next, second case, atom in excited state. In excited state, atom will no longer time stay in excited state. Some few seconds means lifetime. That time is called lifetime. The lifetime of excited state of atom is average value 10⁻⁸ seconds. Then below that lifetime of atom will transition from excited state to ground state with releasing the some energy. It releasing the some energy the form of photon. That photon value equals to h mu. This is spontaneous emission. Third case is stimulated emission of radiation. Same process, atom is in excited state. Then consider the external supplying energy. External supplying energy, that atom that time transition from ground excited state to ground state, it will release the one photon energy and instant photon also. This case, two photons, one is emission of radiation, emission photon, another is incident photon. These two are coherence, means in phase. It moves the same direction. It follows the same direction. Like chalk piece and duster, both are different way. So already moving of duster at one place, incident photon will join the duster place to move the duster this direction from another. These both are in same direction, that is called as in phase. Okay, in that excited atom is moves along with external energy source, means external photon. These two photons, one is emission photon, another is incident photon, in coherence, means in phase, both are in phase. In spontaneous emission, no in phase of photons. Emission, in that photons are coherent in phase. Energy equals to this total energy, system of energy equals to 2 h nu. Again, these two, one incident and one instant and one emission of photon is considered as transition atoms. These two again introduce the transition goes to the 2 transition, then it will release the 4 emission of radiations, 4 H mu's. Again, these 4 H mu's, 4 emission of radiations will participate in again next level. It will produce the 8 H mu's. Again, 8 H mu's involved in the stimulated emission. Then it will produce the, it will, process is going on up to N H mu. That's why light intensity compared to laser, laser is very high intensity. Based on this property only, laser works. Laser property based on this process only by stimulated emission of radiation. Thank you.